What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. So you guys already know what time it is. It is Wednesday. I'm about to turn this fan on because I'm hot. It's freaking holy hell right now. Like, I'm fucking hot right now, okay? So yes, it's Real Talk Wednesday. And in case y'all is like, ooh, girl, that hair is on fleek. I know. But if y'all missed the video for this hair, I showed you exactly how I made this with the highlights and all, baby. Yes. Then go ahead and head on to my main channel, which is only one channel. I don't even know why I said that. But anyway, and the video is right there. But if I remember, I will post it below for you guys. So I show you a full talk-through tutorial. So if you guys have patience and can, pay attention for more than 12 minutes, then watch the video. Some people be like, oh, that is too long. Bitch, what the fuck? How you supposed to learn in 2 minutes? That's why your ass is dumb right now. I'm just saying. But yes, I give you a full tutorial on how I made this wig. Not the sewing techniques. That's another video, because then that would probably be like another 12 minutes. And I know some people's attention span ain't really that long. So I made it like about 12, 13 minutes. And it shows you how I color the wig, okay? How I color the bundles to get it this beautiful blonde streaks and what have you, highlights, what have you. So, yes. And for those of you who have sent me well wishes on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, private email, and even on video comments, thank you so much. So, as you guys know, this past Friday, I did go have surgery. I had a partial hysterectomy, which I'm like, you know, cool about. Let me tell y'all something. I don't even remember them telling me to count backwards, okay? I remember the part when they put the IV in me, and that was not even for the drugs for me to go to sleep. That was for just to relax me. Then I remember them scooting me through the hallway on the bed, on the gurney, into the operating room. And I remember this black nurse above me, and I was like, I love your lashes. And I told her I loved her eyelashes because I really did like her eyelashes. They were strip lashes, but I really did like them. And I was like, I love, she was standing right over me. So I was like, I love your lashes. And she was like, thank you. And that's all I recall. Like, I don't remember anything else after that. I don't remember them telling me to count backwards. The next thing I remember, or count, whatever. The next thing I remember is waking up, okay? And this fucking obnoxious nurse talked about stop moving because my blood pressure is going up. Like, bitch, shut the fuck up, okay? She was like really getting on my nerves, okay? Asking me, do I take medication for my high blood pressure? I was like, no, I don't have high blood pressure unless you pissing me off. I don't have high blood pressure unless somebody, like, if I'm angry or I'm stressed out, then that's when my blood pressure is high. But other than that, I'm cool. But if you piss me off, then of course my blood pressure gets really high. And I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one that's like that, but she just kept insisting that I took medication. Bitch, I think I know the fuck I take. Anyway, she gave me this big ass booklet of care instructions to my daughter. Told me my son couldn't come in. All this kind of bullshit. And then she was like, well, this is, you can't drink. Okay, whatever. Bitch, I had a drink today. Okay, I had a drink today. It's Tuesday. By the time this video goes up, it'll be Wednesday. But she just was really getting on my nerves. So she just kept on with the freaking, you can't drink. Like, I'm some type of alcoholic. I don't know why she kept telling me that. So this is what I did to her. I said, well, if you can't drink because I'm taking these Percocets that y'all gave me, can I smoke some weed? Yes, the bitch did ask, because she was like, I said, yes, can I smoke some weed then later on tonight? Since you're talking about some pain, can I smoke some marijuana? Because I got a bong at home and I got some medical marijuana that I want to smoke. She just was like, I guess that's okay. Did you think that, bitch, you kept talking about you can't drink. Okay, so a bitch did have a drink today, okay, my first drink since like Wednesday. Oh, it's like almost a week, but whatever, you know what I'm saying? But the surgery went well, okay. I was in pain. My son, I drove myself there, and my son came and got me, and he drove my car home. So they took like my Lyft or Uber, they took Uber there, him and Tati. I was pissed because they didn't let my son in, this fucking nurse. Anyway, the other nurse, her name is Suzanne. Oh my God, Susie. Her name was Susie, excuse me. Oh my God. She was like the best. You ever get those nurses who are just like the perfect fucking nurse? She was so cool. Like, let me tell you, first of all, they they was like, you can't wear no moisturizer, you can't wear no makeup, you can't do this. I was like, God damn. And this is what they was telling me 24 hours prior on the phone. And I was like, can I wear my wig? And she was like, yeah, you can wear your wig. This on the phone, right? And I was like, all right, so cool. I'm going to wear this wig. I put this, not this one, but my other little lace front one. You know what I'm saying? Of course, you know, I had the combs in and stuff, a little elastic band. I was like, okay. And I didn't have no makeup on, but I said, okay, I'm going to still look cute. Somewhat cute. Had a little cornrow here and there, looking cute and decent. And I drew me on some eyebrows. I know they say you can't wear no makeup, but it's just eyebrows. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, so I went there and the nurse Susie, she was mad cool, was in my room. She was like, do you have any metal in your head? I was like, no. She was like, do you have any bobby? I said, I do have bobby pins. And she was like, all right. And I was like, wait a minute, hold up, I got a wig on. She was like, you got combs in them. And this is a white nurse. And I was like, yeah. She was like, you cannot wear that. I was like, you told me I can't wear my wig? I can't wear my... Wait a minute. I was like, I asked the lady on the phone, could I wear my wig? And she was like, yes. She's like, no, girl. She's like, listen, I know I'm white, but I know about these wigs. She's like, trust me, I know about these wigs. They got those metal combs and you cannot wear that. And your head might catch on fire. I was like, wait, what? Something with the machines and something about the laser things that they doing that I was like, okay, listen, I don't want my head to catch on fire. I was like, but I cannot go in there like this with my little fishnet head stocking on. She was like, I'm going to get you a bonnet, okay? I'm going to make sure you be all right. She made sure I was all right. I had this cute little blue bonnet on and shit. Oh, my God. I was looking cute. Okay. My little eyebrows, whatever. She gave me a special bag for my wig. Let me tell you. And I told her, listen, this is not no cheap synthetic wig. Now, this is all right? So, I told her that. And she put in a special bag. She made sure to watch my stuff and everything. So, when I woke up, please tell me why a bitch did not have her blue bonnet on. Did this motherfucking nurse that I did not like, who I told I was about to smoke some weed to, because she was just really obnoxious. I was like, where's my bonnet? She was like, oh, I took it off and threw it in the trash. I was like, why would you throw my bonnet in the trash? Because you didn't need it no more. I was like, do you see how I'm looking right now? And she was like, okay, but you... I was like, listen, I'm going to need a bonnet, all right? I'm going to need a bonnet because I'm kind of drugged up and I'm really not in the mood to put and fix a wig right now. Oh, wait, well, I threw it in the trash. I said, well, maybe you should just go give me another one. Who even told you to take my bonnet off in the first place? Yeah, this bitch went out and got me another bonnet. And then when she brought me my shit, I tried to put my wig on. I had to use my camera on my phone to try and look cute. She was like, no, it looks good. It looks good. Susie came in, thank God. She gave me a hug and stuff. And she was like, I told you I would come and see you. And I was like, look at my wig. She was like, yeah, put your bonnet on, honey. Put your bonnet on over the wig. But this bitch telling me it looked cool. So when Tati, my daughter, came in, she was like, no, mommy, leave your bonnet on. Leave your bonnet on. It looks, you can see it. So you was going to send me out there with a fishnet cap on. And on top of that, you was going to send me out there with my wig looking jacked the fuck up. I'm already fucked up, like drugged up. But you going to... Listen, no matter how fucked up you get, don't mean you gotta look fucked up, all right? On some real shit, you don't have to look fucked up. So that was my experience. I took my ass home. My son drove me home. Please tell me why my son drives so close to the motherfucking curb, okay? Like, I had to tell him several times, could you please move over from the curb? And why is you driving so slow? Well, you just got out of surgery. That don't mean you gotta drive like you driving Miss Daisy. Nigga, I'm not that motherfucking old and you can drive. Driving like 20 and the speed limit is 45. Like, really? I want to go home. I want to get home within the next few minutes. Not within the next couple of hours. Okay? Just listen. It was just like, I'm just so thankful that girls are so responsible and that my daughter Tati took care of me, because I love my son to death, but he cannot drive. He drive too close to the curb. He drive too motherfucking slow. He talked too much. Like, I wanted to just be like, could you just shut the fuck up, all right? I don't really care. I don't really fucking care right about now about what you're talking about. I don't even know what you're talking about, nigga. I'm high off of fucking drugs that they gave me. Not weed, but drugs, which is even more serious. Shut the fuck up and bring me home. When I got home, the only thing that I wanted to see was my mumsy and my Tinky Man, my grandson. That's all I kept asking for in the hospital the whole entire time. And I was so glad to get home. I was able to see my grandson and my daughter because, of course, there was no school on Friday because Veterans Day. So, yeah, us. And when I got home, my daughter Tati, she's so overprotective, like overly overprotective. She made me go upstairs, made me soup, made me something to eat, made me go to sleep. Well, she didn't make me go to sleep. I went to sleep automatically, so you know what I'm saying. And they gave me these Percocets, and yes, very, very strong drug. Okay, let me tell y'all that. I was knocked the fuck out. I don't even remember her going to her job in my car. I know I woke up with a puddle of drool on my face. But other than that, I'm cool now. You know what I'm saying? It was a partial, so I was so happy with that, because the full hysterectomy, I wouldn't have been able to handle that. You guys know I cannot be out of commission for like 4 to 5 weeks. I have a grandson to watch. I have things to do. So I cannot be bed rested for like 4 to 5 weeks. So the few days that I got was perfect. And now I'm back to normal. I'm feeling like a new, well, I'm feeling the same. You know what I'm saying? I haven't done a video since last week. All the videos that you've seen have already been pre-recorded. And this is the first video that I have recorded since my surgery. And I'm really happy about that. However, one of these companies that I will be reviewing within this week, if you call me and I'm half asleep and then I tell you I just get out of surgery, bitch, don't ask me about, well, how did I like the clothes? And, oh, I'm so sorry to hear that, but did you like the clothes? Really? You know what? A lot of these companies have really bad mannerism, and I really am not the one to fuck with, okay? Because I will blow your whole shit up and let people know what type of person you are. If I tell you that I just got out of surgery and you could tell that I'm sleeping, I don't give a fuck about your clothing, okay? I really don't care. When I do the video, you guys know. You guys know. You guys know. But anyway, other than that, I'm feeling really great. So I thank everyone for sending me well wishes and checking on me. I'm doing well. I'm back to April and hopefully my periods. No, you guys don't want to hear that. But we'll like be regular. Wow. Okay. But other than that, yeah. So make sure you stay tuned for the video. Also, there's another video today because, you know, I post two on Wednesdays. So make sure you guys stay tuned for that. Sometimes they're beauty related. Sometimes they're not. Either way, there'll be another video posted for the day. So if you have a real talk situation that you want to be discussed on my channel, make sure you send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please post the word real talk in the subject line. Please make sure to change the names of your characters, your subjects in the email, and let me know that. So that way I do not have to change them. And other than that, you guys, bitches, let's get on to this real talk, y'all. Okay. All right, so let's get on to this. This is a really short one, and I'm really happy about that. Hi, I'm Suzette. Just wanted to let you know I love your channel. I need your advice. I'm 20 years old, and I've been in a relationship for 4 years, but he recently broke up with me, lack of trust. So she changed her name to Suzette. Excuse me. Our relationship... He recently broke up with me from lack of trust. So she's 20 years old and she's been in a relationship for 4 years. But he recently broke up with me for lack of trust. Our relationship haven't been good all the time. We were both young in high school when we dated and we did dumb stuff. But over the years, we both got older and mature. Recently, we broke up for about 2 months. And during that time, I did talk to other men to fill in that void. We decided to make things work and I told him everything and that was going on while we broke up and was honest. I never slept with no other men. I just was talking. When we got back together, I could feel it was different. He would get annoyed when I would come around, and numerous times he would tell me he doesn't have feelings for me and he can't let go of the past. So recently he broke up with me and he's trying to make it my fault, saying I'm rushing him into relationship. All I wanted was him to be honest and real with me. I know my worth and I know how I should be treated, regardless of what mistakes I have done. I tried to make it work, but he can't seem to let go of the past. I never bring up the past with him. I just move forward. Should I just be done with him for good or keep fighting for this relationship? Thank you and God bless. So first of all, Suzette was in a relationship for 4 years. They broke up. She's 20 years old, so they've been together since they were 16. They broke up 2 months into the breakup. She's talking to other guys. No sexual relations. Just talking. Like you and I talk. Oh, what's up, boo? You know, you looking good on that Instagram. Shit like that. Whatever. When they got back together, her and her ex, we're going to call him Billy Ray. When Suzette and Billy Ray got back together, she was honest with him. She told him that, you know, I was talking to other guys. I was not having sex with them. them. I wasn't sexing them. I was talking with them. This guy, Billy Ray, he's just basically getting annoyed with her. He can't let go of the past, saying certain things. So once again, they probably broke up again, and he's saying that she's rushing him into a relationship, and all she basically wanted to do was be real with him and him to be real with her, but she doesn't bring up the past. So should she just let him go? Let me tell you something, Suzette. Now, first of all, that's cool. You was honest with him. You told him what you was doing within those 2 months. He was talking to guys. He wasn't sexing them. However, when y'all got back together, he still keeps throwing this up in your face, telling you that he basically doesn't trust you. His lack of trust is the reason why he broke up with you. He can't let go of the past. He feels as though you are rushing him into a relationship, et cetera, et cetera. But you're not bringing up the past. Let me tell you something about men. Okay, or anyone in general. When they throw shit in your face that you have done and you have told them that you have done, or even if you haven't told them that you have done, but they have found out and they keep throwing the shit up in their face, I want to say like 6 times out of 10, they are doing something behind your back. Okay, that is making them feel self-conscious, and that's their guilt playing games with you. Because I've already been there and done that with my ex-husband. You know what I'm saying? He's done did that same exact shit to me. Now, regardless if he believes you or not, lack of trust, and you already told him that you were in sex with these guys, but you were talking to them. Let me tell you something. At least you were that much honest, because you didn't even have to tell his ass that. Me personally, if it were me, I would have told his fucking ass a goddamn thing, because I don't think it's your business. We ain't been together for 2 months. If he ain't volunteering no motherfucking information, best believe a bitch like me ain't gonna volunteer no information too. I'm not saying we keeping shit in the closet or we keeping secrets. However, some things are just left best unfucking told, because when you tell somebody something, it's like they like to throw it in your face and use it as a guilty conscience, use it towards you as guilt, use it towards you as a fucking game. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, well, this is why I did this to you, because this is why I did this, and because you told me this. This is what people do in general, and I'm not just going to say men. I'm going to say women in general, men in general too, so people in general. And personally, me, I wouldn't have told him anything, because if we ain't together, it's none of your motherfucking business what I've done in 2 months. I could have fucked the whole state of fucking Arizona. That's not your motherfucking business, okay? I don't give a fuck what you did. Don't worry about what the fuck I did. Honestly, truth be told, some things I really don't want to know what you fucking did, okay? Because if we're not together, then we're not together. I don't want to know how you sexed and fucked Janie and how it felt so good. I don't want to know that. Some things are left best not told. Now, here's the thing. If he's telling you lack of trust, nigga, who the fuck is you to be lack of trusting? Because for all I know, you could have been fucking everybody in the fucking schoolhouse and then some, okay? And you're just not volunteering the information. And that's your guilt. A lot of times when men or women come at you and they want to play this guilt game, it has a lot to do with the shit that they've done. When you find and you're in a relationship and they're constantly accusing you of things that you have not even done, it has a lot to do with their guilt. Let's just take, for example, the last relationship that I got out of. Thank God that this nigga is gone with his little ass fucking toddler dick, okay? Yes, Jamel, I'm talking about you if you're watching this. Oh, but you can't be watching this unless they're giving you YouTube access from prison, okay? Now, this nigga would go to New York for like a couple of weeks or whatever. Go outside, pretend like he's exercising. I mean, he did exercise because his fat ass lost a lot of weight. However, okay, let's not forget that I did catch your fucking Facebook page. But either way, and you just couldn't fuck, okay? But I try to look past the fact that you couldn't fuck and that your dick has shrunk over the years from when we used to be together when I was 20. Maybe because you got so fat, your dick got smaller. Either way. Okay. Now, he would constantly say how I was cheating on him, how I was doing this because I didn't want to have sex with him, how I'm probably cheating on him, all kind of shit. But come to find out, I wasn't cheating on you. I'm always in the house, but I wasn't cheating on you. The reason why I didn't want to have sex with you is because you're a lame-o in bed and your dick lasts within 2 to 3 minutes. And it's little. So why would anybody want to have sex with anybody who's got a little dick, for one, and also a little dick that lasts 2 to 3 minutes? No, okay? I'm not going to gas myself up for the fucking excitement when there really isn't any. All right. There have been numerous times when I had to think about my ex-husband while fucking you. And that shit didn't even help. Yes, I said my ex-husband because I'm not even going to front. He was number one in the bed. But, you know, it's fucked up when you got to think about somebody else to get your rocks off. And that shit don't even help. Okay. But either way, he would say shits like that to me about how I was cheating on him, et cetera, et cetera. Come to find out, he was cheating on me. I find him fucking his fat ass on Facebook Messenger. I seen the video on Facebook Messenger on his tablet, his fat fucking ass, okay, fucking his other baby mama. And when I talk to her and I let her know, yeah, I'm going to exploit this video, okay, but then I had to think about it. I said, was you really getting off like that because you was hooting and hollering like it wasn't no tomorrow? She even admitted that she was faking it. So anyway, that's neither here nor there, but we all know that he got a little ass dick and he cannot fuck, okay. If you can't fuck and you got a little ass dick, you should be able to eat pussy good. But you can't even do that. But anyway. Maybe my expectations was a little bit too high because of the last person I've been with for so long. You know what I'm saying? Because he was A1 and everything. So maybe my expectations was a little bit too high for this one person. But I just figured that if you ain't got one thing or two things, then you should have at least the third thing. Anyway. So listen, he would just constantly say I'm playing head games. Not constantly, but enough times he's said I played head games with him, I'm cheating on him, etc., etc. Come to find out, it's you. You was cheating on me. How you gonna cheat on somebody when you can't even fuck and you got a little ass dick and you can't even eat pussy? How you gonna cheat on somebody when you a fat motherfucker and you can't even last that long? When sucking you off, you can't suck you off because your belly is in a motherfucking way. Okay. Oops, did I say that? Okay. So Jamel, if your baby mama is watching, your other baby mama or your fucking ratchet ass family member who was fucking sending me messages on Facebook, yes, I did say that about him, and I did post his mugshot all on Facebook. Yes, it was me. But anyway, like I was saying, niggas and men and bitches who fucking constantly accuse you of doing shit and you know goddamn well that you not doing shit, it be they shit, okay? It be them that is the culprit. It be them that be doing the fucking humping around. It be them that be fucking bitches or niggas behind your motherfucking back. And that's the shit that they do to you to make them feel good about themselves. So listen, if he feel like he can't trust you, and etc., etc., let me tell you something. Like you said, you already know your worth. Why let somebody fucking dog you the fuck out by running their mouth? And to me, I feel like he's dogging you out by saying, oh, you doing this, oh, you doing that, I don't trust you. Nigga, if you don't fucking trust me in the first time, you got one time to tell me you don't trust me. And if you tell me you don't trust me, then it's a wrap. Deuces, bye Felicia, bye. Because I'm not gonna be with anybody who don't trust me, okay? If you tell me that, if you come out your mouth and you open your motherfucking mouth and tell me you don't trust me, then there's no reason for us to be together. Please explain to me what's the reason for us being together, okay? Like, I have already been through this. I have been married and have been with my ex-husband for so long, okay, before we were even married. So I already know the bullshit and the schemes, and he's even told me this. What I'm just telling you about how they tell you that you're cheating because they want to rectify what they're doing is right, my ex-husband already explained this to me when he cheated on me. He explained this to me. So I got it from the fucking pig's mouth, okay? From the fucking pig's mouth. He's told me this. So this is where I get a lot of my fucking shit from, because of my ex-husband and what he sat me down and told me. At least he was man enough to be honest and tell me that shit. You know what I'm saying? And it's truth. It's truth because I have noticed this. You know what I'm saying? You wanted somebody that was going to be real with you and you was real with him, but honestly, he couldn't step up to the plate. So my thing to you is this: if he can't feel like he can trust you, lack of trust, etc., etc., then you know what? It's deuces. It's deuces. Excuse me. You guys have been together for 4 years. You feel like you guys have grown and matured. Sweetheart, let me tell you something, Suzette. You're only 20 years old. You ain't matured. You just reached the teen phase out of that shit. You just came out of the teen phase. You still a kid. You guys were together since y'all was 16. Y'all didn't know shit then, and y'all really don't know shit now. So my best bet to you is this. Yeah, 4 years may seem long to some, but to me, it's really not that long. It is long compared to 2 to 3 to 4 months relationship or a year or two relationship. Yes, 4 years is longer than 1 or 2 years. However, that shit is not longer than fucking 17 years what I had to deal with, okay? So here's my thing, and this is just me honestly speaking to you. You may have feelings for him, but why lower yourself and why let your self-esteem be lowered and buried because of someone else and their lack of trust towards you? If he's not doing anything behind your back, then hallelujah, hallelujah. However, if he is constantly telling you that he does not trust you, I'm not going to allow anybody to badger me with that guilt. If I know in my heart that me as a person, April, has not done any of that, I am not about to allow you to badger me. Okay, maybe I might have been somewhat wrong for talking to other men. However, we were not together at that time frame. So I was allowed to do whatever the fuck I please to do, just as well as you. But if you are going to badger me and put me down because of it, then that is a lack of respect for you, okay, as a person, regardless of your sex, meaning male or female. It's a lack of respect for you as a person. And as well as that, is there's no concern for your feelings. And I'm pretty sure that he would not like for you to do the same to him if the shoe was on the other foot. So therefore, Suzette, if he is going to constantly badger you about it and he feels like you rushed him into a relationship, the best thing you can do is let this motherfucker fly the fuck off, okay? Let him go. And a lot of times it's hard for people to let a relationship go when they feel like they're never going to get over it. They love this person so much, and I get it. I fucking get it. We do love. We love very strong. We love these people that we are with, and we want to be with them for the rest of their lives, and we say that we're going to be with them for the rest of our lives, and this is just us talking at the time period. However, you have to think about who you are as a person and your feelings. Would you let somebody badger you and constantly put you down for doing something that you haven't done? No, I'm not going to deal with the accusation. And I'm just not. If I did something and I didn't relate to it, I didn't relate you to it, I didn't tell you about it, then that's one thing. However, if you know in your heart and in yourself that you did not do anything like what he's saying, a lack of trust, then don't allow him to badger you, okay? Don't allow him to lower you and any lower than you already feel. I'm sorry, I don't give a fuck who you are. Man, woman, child, whoever, I am not about to allow you to badger me as a person and put me down because you feel like I've done something behind your back. You know what I'm saying? We all love. We try to love strong. Some people don't love as strong as we do. They don't put as much love and concern into a relationship, and that's unfortunate. But you know what? Some of these relationships that we are in are only life lessons. They're not to be dealt with and to be in for the rest of our lives. They're called life lessons, and we're only in them for a temporary moment to learn from and then to move on and to bring something better into a next relationship. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes when we break up with people for 2 months, it doesn't mean that we can talk to every Tom, Dick, and Harry. And I'm not saying that you're thotty or you shouldn't have, but me personally, I would not have talked to any other guy. That's just me personally, because I would try to find myself, find my soul, and just figure out what the fuck I want and why our relationship is not going great. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. A lot of bitches these days, they leave one relationship and then they jump into another one. They cannot fucking be still. They cannot just be by themselves. And I don't understand why. You know what I'm saying? If you just left somebody that was stressing you the fuck out, why would you want to be with somebody else that's stressing you the fuck out? Like, I don't know. I don't get it. I don't really get it. I mean, I'm sorry. I would need a fucking break. A nigga stressing me the fuck out. I'm not about to go to the next nigga stressing me the fuck out, because then I probably will flip the fuck out. But it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? And in my opinion, I would not allow him to stress me the fuck out and badger me. I just wouldn't. Me personally, I don't allow anybody to fucking badger me. If you got some smart shit to say, we gonna handle this like motherfuckers, and we gonna handle it. And if you don't trust me, then you don't trust me. Bottom line. Okay, so this one seems like it's about to be good, okay? Real talk, need advice on a mature PYT situation. If y'all don't know what PYT is, you know, remember that song by Michael Jackson? PYT, Pretty Young Thing, okay? So, thank you in advance for taking the time to actually read this. Let me first say, I really do like your video posts. I am just now getting into reviewing and keeping up with posts. So, I went back and reviewed a few of your older posts. But thank you, girl. You're very witty and just just be keeping it 100 on your opinions and responses. I like it a lot. Keep showing the hair products in different styles. I am transitioning into the natural world and your posts are making it easy. So anywho, I am writing to get your 100% opinion, and if you need to post this on your Keeping Real post, totally fine with it. Please just don't use my name. But I am 35 years old and I met a mature young guy, 29, online. I am enjoying his company and conversations. We went on a few dates and I like that. He's a total gentleman, opens my car door, sends me polite morning texts, asks me about my day, just very attentive. He actually has goals in place to pursue his chef cooking career, owns a small growing catering company, has a couple clients he personally cooks for, all around good guys so far. Now, dating can be a hit or miss, but I like that. Our conversation is not about what club you go to or you smoke. Definitely not the stereotype for a young guy that I had in mind. He wants a family and would like to get married one day. So I asked one evening, is there anything I should know that I wouldn't think to ask? He was very hesitant in sharing this particular story. Last year, he had sex with a transgender. He was dating a young woman for a while who's bisexual and wanted to explore like she did, but not with a male figure, someone a bit feminine than manly male. He told me the experience wasn't what he thought. The transgender didn't want to kiss, no fondling, he couldn't get it up. He did try receiving bottom and stating it is very uncomfortable. So he gave me all of these details because I asked, and I wanted to see if this was just an experience, like he claims, or did he enjoy what he experienced. He states that was an experience, something he explored. He doesn't want to explore that or experience anything else with a man, transgender or bisexual, nothing. Only a couple of people, including the woman he dated, knows about this. His family doesn't know. A couple of close-knit friends and me know. Now, we never been intimate, just nice long after-date kisses before this story. Now, I can't get this story out of my mind. Okay. I only saw him twice after him telling me this, and it was to meet for coffee and another time for drinks. Obviously, I still like this dude. Characteristics are on point so far. Only been 2 months of knowing him. Personally, I would have took something like that to my grave, especially if I didn't want to do it again. But everyone is different. He recently told me that I treat him different and he regrets telling me about his past. He feels that I think he'll do it again, and I don't believe him when he says I'm done with that. He's right. I have treated him different. When he mentions guys' nights out, I ask, what does that mean? Or what does that entail? When he says I'm going to have a drink with a friend, I ask, guy or girl? Yeah, I do treat him different. I told a few of my close friends, and one was like, what happens? See what happens. And my homegirl was like, don't kiss him. And I'm a better one than her if I continue to see him. What do you think? I'm a bit like you. I tend to talk a lot, but I had to get my thoughts out. So please excuse a long email. Please advise. What should I do? What would you do? Okay, so we're going to call her Nancy. So Nancy met this guy online. He's real nice and everything. She 35, he 29 and everything, blah, blah, blah. So he told her one of his little secrets that he was dating this girl that wanted to be that's bisexual. So she wanted to try it out, and he wanted to try it out too, experiment. So they experimented with a transgender, okay? Well, the transgender was the transgender sex that he was. So the transgender had a dick, okay? And so the transgender didn't kiss him, was no fondling, he couldn't get his dick hard, and basically he tried to be a bottom for the transgender, but it was uncomfortable, and she's been treating him different. What would Listen, his qualities are all there. She said all of that. Let me tell y'all something, okay? I don't have anything about against anybody being gay, bisexual, transgender, any of that, transsexual. I don't care what you are in life, you know what I'm saying? Because we're all human beings. But I draw a fine line when it comes to stuff like this. Like, you want to experiment. Like, okay, listen. All right, listen. This one kind of has got me, like, to the left, because I don't want anybody to think different of me as a person. But if somebody I was messing with came and told me that they was experimenting and they had sex with a transgender and they tried to be a bottom, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna just tell you, you know what, dude, I can't fuck with you no more. I'm gonna just say it just like that. And it's not because I have anything against transgenders or transsexuals or bisexuals or gays. It's not because of that. It's because I have something against what the fuck you did. You either gonna be one way or not, okay? And if you are bisexual, then you need to find somebody that's into that lifestyle. And me personally, you're not about to make me feel uncomfortable in myself and in my own motherfucking skin and my own motherfucking shoes. Because a bitch don't like to be uncomfortable in her shoes, okay? Because I will kick the motherfuckers right the fuck off and start walking barefooted, all right? So, with that being said, you treating him different is because you feel uncomfortable. And, all right, if that's what he wants to experience and experiment, then, okay, kudos to you. Everybody experiments with all kind of shit. That's their business, okay? You cannot judge the person as a person. But if it makes you feel lesser and that's not what you into, then that's not what you into, and your friend is right. That would be me personally. I would be like, girl, you a better one than me, because it wouldn't be me. All right, I'm sorry, but it just wouldn't be me. Nothing against that, but there are all kind of diseases. And not only that, but even if there's all kind of diseases, whatever, even if you using a condom, I just don't need you fucking playing game head games with me. If you want to experiment, then go motherfucking experiment. By all means, go in the motherfucking lab, get you some motherfucking experimental shit and experiment all goddamn day. All right, that's your business. But if you are going to experiment, please let me know, so that way I could allow you to be who you be. Now, I know that it's making you feel uncomfortable because you're treating him differently. And honestly, if someone was to tell me that I was dating, I probably would have a mouth wide open drop. Like even if he had life goals, I don't really give a fuck about them. Them life goals would have been out the window, because how I really know that's your life goals? Nigga, you could be talking just to be talking. You know, some people talk just to be talking. They could tell you everything until the sky is blue and until the moon turn red. They could tell you shit that you want to motherfucking hear. Like, yeah, I'm about to be a chef and I do this and I do that and I do this and I do that. That's shit that you want to hear. Not necessarily take it serious all the time. When people tell you something, don't necessarily take it serious. Like, yeah, this is them. This is who they are. This is what the fuck they gonna do with themselves. Don't fucking take that shit grade A1 all the time. You know, some people just talk to get to your panties, okay? Or to your underwear or to your boxers. Bitches talk, niggas talk. They talk a good game. So his life goals may be life goals, but that might not be his motherfucking life goals. His life goals might be freaky deaky and off. Who the fuck knows what his life goals is? But I'm telling you what, though. If I was to hear some shit like that, I'm not fucking with you. I'm not fucking with you. And I'm not fucking with you because, for one, I'm feeling like you got some kind of gay tendencies or some bisexual tendencies, and I'm not into that shit. You know what I'm saying? Not saying that it's a bad thing. Not saying that, oh, I don't like gay people, or I don't like transgenders, or I don't like transsexuals, because I love them to death. I love everybody. I don't give a fuck if you were purple and you came down from the goddamn sky in a UFO. You had these big ass black eyes. As long as you respect me, then we can hang out and chill all motherfucking day, okay? Let me tell you something. Honestly, I'd rather hang out with gay guys than bitches sometimes, okay? Because some females can be so motherfucking catty, okay? And just always trying to compete with one another. And I'm not into that competition shit. Because 9 times out of 10, bitch, if you keep trying to motherfucking compete with me, I'm going to cut your throat and I'm going to win at the end, okay? And that's just a metaphor. That's just how I feel. And I really don't feel like I should have to compete with anybody. But bitches is snakes and bitches is catty. And that's why I don't have a lot of female friends, okay? Because they come and go like the fucking Four Seasons. And one minute they like you, the next minute they don't motherfucking like you. One minute they talking about you on social media, and then the next minute they unfriending you on Facebook. Bitch, I don't really give a fuck, okay? Let me tell you that at the end of the day, April don't give a fuck. But I'm going to tell you what. I don't dislike gays. I don't dislike transgenders. However, if I'm dating someone and he come to me and he tell me some story like that, then I'm just going to have to question who the fuck you are. And me, as a realist, I'm going to just have to let you know, listen, I love your goals. I love your goals. Not you, motherfucker. I love the goals that you have set for yourself. But I really don't think that you're really being honest with yourself and you don't know what you want. And with that being said, I really can't mess with you. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that it's wrong to feel that way. I'm not saying that it's right to feel that way. But some people are very uncomfortable with that. And me, personally, if I'm going to mess with a man, I want him to be a man. A manly man. I don't want him to be experimenting with transgenders and anything like that. You know what I'm saying? And not like I said, again, once again, I have nothing against it, okay? But that's just not who I am. And like you asked me, what would I do? I would just let him know, listen, what you told me, I appreciate your honesty. And that's one thing that I appreciate. I really appreciate your honesty, but I'm about to be real and honest with you. That didn't sit well with me, and it didn't make me very comfortable as a person. And with that being said, I just really feel like we should remain friends and nothing more than that. Because he's probably a really great person to be as friends with, but as a sexual mate and relationship, I'm really not too sure about that because he doesn't seem too sure about himself. If you want to experiment, what is the reason for you wanting to experiment? You want to experiment for certain reasons, and for those reasons, I don't know, bro, man. I'm gonna have to just leave you the fuck alone. And that's cool. He was honest. Like, me, personally, I don't think I would tell anybody that shit, okay? Especially being a man. Like, that's a little bit hard. Man, if you tell a man, like, yeah, I've experimented with some female, they'd probably be all for it. You know what I'm saying? That's like if I was gay. Like, if I loved girls and I didn't want to be with a guy, and then my girlfriend came and told me that she just experimented with a dude, I would be like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Like, what? You don't know what you want? That would make me feel some type of way, too. And I might have to get rid of that bitch because now you like dick. You know what I'm saying? So, either way, it wouldn't have freaking sat comfortable with me. And I don't know. If somebody was to tell me some shit like that, I would probably be like, man, stop playing. Stop playing. But he was dead serious, and he should have took that shit to his grave, just like you fucking said. I don't think I would have told anybody that. And me personally, I don't think I would have told any of my friends that, yeah, the dude that I was talking to, you know, he was about to get it in the butt. What? I wouldn't have said that shit, because my friends would have been clowning me to the end. I'd be like, girl, remember that time when you was talking about that guy that you met online and he was talking about he was trying to experiment and shit and he couldn't get it hard, but he was experimenting with somebody with a dick? Bitch, don't be telling your friends that shit. Some shit you gotta keep to your motherfucking self. Seriously. Yeah, some real shit, I think I'd have been ghost. Like, yeah. I don't even think I would have told me that to publish on Real Talk. So, yeah, girl. I think he's just leaving the fuck alone because he's a little confused. And as much as you like his lifetime goals and his mannerism and shit, bitch, there's a whole lot of motherfuckers out there that got good mannerism and know what the fuck they want. Okay? Yes. Okay, so this is going to be the last one of the evening. Hello, April. Hope all is well with you and your family. I'm writing to you for advice and also as a way to vent. You can call me Sabrina. Changed my name so you wouldn't have to. Okay, me and my fiance have been together for about 4 to 5 years. We both have children outside of our relationship, as well as 2 daughters together. From start, our relationship has been rough, cheating, family drama, etc. Some things have changed for the better as far as him cheating goes, but other things not so much. April, I feel I no longer want to be with him. I don't feel the same way I used to feel about him. My fiance is 29 years old and very immature. Half of the time, he doesn't even know how to treat me as a woman. I myself am 29 years old. I recently had a bad falling out with his mother and his grandmother as well. His daughter always stays with the grandma as if that's her home. Recently, it was revealed that she lied to his mother about not wanting to be here. Now, the problem is, amongst others, is that he hasn't handled the situation. Lying on someone about a serious matter could get someone in trouble, especially when it isn't true. This is not the first time it came up that me and his daughter don't get along. I tried building a relationship with her, but to no avail. We're back to this point again. Part of me doesn't want to let him go because I feel we can fix things. But then again, it's like I'm getting fed up. I barely even want to have intercourse with him because that's how distant I am from him. He's insecure and has anger problems as well. April, I just want to be happy. Could you give me some advice, please, even if it's not on Real Talk? Thanks. So she said she changed her name to Sabrina. So basically, her and her man have been together. They got two daughters together. They got a child outside of the relationship before they even met. He got a daughter. I'm not sure if she got a daughter or a son outside of the relationship, but this is before they met. But basically, her and his daughter don't get along. He's lying. She had a falling out with his mother and his motherfucking grandmother. She feels distant. She don't want to have sex with him. Basically, she don't want to be with him, but she feels like she can fix things. Let me tell you something, Sabrina. Sometimes, in a relationship, we feel like we want to fix things because we love them so much. And there is a fine line between love and hate. Yes, you may feel distance and you may feel hatred towards him and you may dislike him. You don't want to feel like you want to have sex with him. However, you still do love him. And that part of you is the portion that wants to try to fix it. And there is really nothing wrong with wanting to try to fix a relationship with anybody. As well as that is because you got children together. However, if you guys aren't getting along and your family members and you and him ain't getting along, then maybe you guys need to take some time off. I'm not saying break up and leave one another alone, but maybe you guys need to have some alone and distant time from one another so that way you can see where you really want to be, and maybe you can see the qualities in each other and learn to miss each other and grasp back together as a whole. Maybe he needs to work things out with his daughter so that way he don't have to feel like he gotta lie about some shit. You don't have to feel like, oh, she's just an obligation because that's his daughter, but y'all really don't get along, you know what I'm saying? And shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's great when you got a family unit and y'all all can get together, but then it's not great when you're not getting along with your in-laws. Trust me, I've been there. I've had fist fights with my ex-husband's mother because that bitch came to my motherfucking door, okay? And it's ready to fight me. All kind of shit. And that shit is a headache in itself. And because of that, you know what I'm saying? I never let that bitch know where I moved to and none of that shit. But it's not even a headache. It's a fucking embarrassment. Like, who goes around wanting to disagree and fight with family members? Like, that's just really dysfunctional. And I mean, yes, nobody's family is perfect. Some people try to play and portray like, oh, we all good and we get along real good, when you know, bitch, your family is dysfunctional as the motherfucking hillbillies and rednecks down the street, okay? So don't front like your shit is better than anybody else. I'm gonna be the first to tell you, my family is dysfunctional. We don't get along. I don't speak to my mama. I just had to go off on her a few weeks ago when I spoke to her finally, and she thought that I was pregnant because I was at the doctor's office. All kind of shit, you know what I'm saying? And it's sad to say, but we don't get along. I don't speak to her. Sometimes I don't speak to my eldest son because he run his mouth and he says some shit that I don't like. So it's a whole bunch of shit. So ain't nobody's family perfect. So let's get that straight. However, sometimes you gotta take a break from your family members or from the ones you love. Just like me, I had to block my son from calling me, and I have blocked him probably for like 3 weeks now, 3 to 4 weeks now, just because, you know what I'm saying? Just because I don't speak to my mom, whatever. We won't speak probably for like another year or so, and if that's what it takes, then that's what the fuck it takes. But here's my thing. I block you motherfuckers because I'm not about to get a headache, and I'm not about to be stressed the fuck out and irritated, and on top of that, y'all motherfuckers is gonna respect me whether you like me the fuck or not. You're gonna respect me. You ain't about to call my motherfucking phone up or text me with no dumb shit. You either gonna respect me or leave me the fuck alone. And that's just my bottom line with everybody in the family. If you can't respect me, then leave me the fuck alone. So with that being said, if his mama and his grandmama can't respect you, then leave the motherfuckers the fuck alone and take a break. Because sometimes we need to take a chill pill. Sometimes we need to take a break from those that we really love just so we can see clear and get past all this fucking bullshit. So maybe we could come to terms and work things out. Not saying leave him the fuck alone. Not saying break up, separate, but separate for a time period so that way you can get your shit back in order. If you feel like you can fix things, so sometimes you gotta fix things from afar. You know what I'm saying? Because when y'all together all the time and y'all in the same household, that shit cannot be motherfucking fixed because you in my face constantly, and nigga, I can't stand you, your bitch ass mama, or your bitch ass old grandmother. Point blank, period. You know what I'm saying? So in my perspective, and in my opinion, sometimes you gotta walk away for a time being, and hopefully shit gets better on the outside. You know what I'm saying? You gotta fix it from afar, because you got too many people meddling in your business. And obviously, his family is meddling in your business. Because if they hadn't been meddling in your business, bitch, you wouldn't be arguing with them. He got a grandmother. Bitch, you old. What the fuck is you? Or arguing with somebody. Mind your motherfucking neck. Mind your fucking neck, like I tell people. Mind that shit. Worry about your old ass, okay? Worry about what the fuck you doing. Worry about your old motherfucking ass. And his mama too. Bitch, worry about your old ass. You know what I'm saying? I don't meddle in my kids' affairs, because as long as you don't fucking put your hands on none of my kids, then we cool. But the minute you do, bitch, you better watch the fuck out. Or nigga, you better watch out, because I will cut your fucking throat like a butcher in the shop. Alright? However, his family need to mind their business. And for you, Sabrina, I would take a break. I would take a break, because y'all got kids together. Let him see the kids, but take a break and try to mend things apart. Sometimes, like I said, you got to mend shit away. All right? Point blank, period. So, on that note, I hope you guys enjoyed this real talk. Make sure y'all check out my hair video, y'all, for this hair. Let me know what you think of it. And as always, stay diva and divalicious. I love you guys. And once again, thank you for making sure that I'm okay. A bitch is still here. I'm still here. And I will see you guys on a soon-to-come video.